Good if you ask. Good if you ask at all. We are welcome to another episode of the healing. I'm your regular civic education teacher by name, Emeka Kolaole. Today we are going to look at a rule of law. Rule of law is one of the important concepts in civic education. Rule of law was a major concept in civic education, and it was Professor Kebbi State about 1985, about 135 years ago, that was the first scholar to have come up with a very clear principle of rule of law. We are going to look at those principles that underline or underlying severe rule of law. The first one is supremacy of law. Supremacy of law. Secondly, we have equality before the law. Equality before the law. Number three. Fundamental human rights of individual must be respected. Fundamental human rights. Human rights. It's a major cardinal point in rule of law. I'm going to explain each of these principles. Remember, I said there are three principles that explain the meaning of rule of law. Each of the principles are very important. But before we go to that, what is the meaning of rule of law? In a very simple, qualified language, you can see that rule of law simply states that all government officials, all the civil servants, all the police, all the civil defense, all the customs officer, the governor, the president, the lawmakers, the minister, all of them must conduct the activities. I mean, when they are carrying out their normal official duty, according to the laid down law, they must not do anything contrary to the speculated law, contrary to what the law says. If they do that, they can be punished personally because they are going beyond the power given to them. So, rule of law simply means that all the government officials, all the activities of the government must be conducted according to the rules and regulations of the country, according to the stipulated laws in the constitution. You still remember our constitution. Constitution is very important in a democratic system of governance. We cannot do without a constitution. So we do everything according to the dictates of the constitution. So having that in your mind, rule of law simply means that there must be supremacy of law. There must be supremacy of law. What does that mean? What does that indicate? Supremacy of law. Anytime you go to the court, you see one logo. You see somebody with dagger and then with a stick. With something like a scaffold. At least it's not looking at anybody. Law is above everybody. Yes. Whether you are a king, you are Obi, you are emir, you are rich, you are poor, you are president, whatever your status in society, you are under the law. You must not do anything arbitrarily apart from what the law gives you the power to do. You are a custodian of power given to you by constitution. So you must act in line with what the law states. So the supremacy of law says that law is above everybody. no matter your status in society, no matter your level of education, no matter your level of economic activities or economic status, excuse me, you must obey the law of the land. Everybody is below the law. Secondly, we look at equality before the law. Yes, of course we say that the law is supreme. It is the supreme authority. Everybody is under it. So, equality means that law treats everybody equally. Law treats everybody equally. The law that is applicable to the rich is also applicable to the poor. The law that is applicable to the illiterate, the same law should be applicable to the elite. So law is treat everybody equally, no matter your status. No matter your status, it treats you equally. Thirdly, the fundamental human rights. You still remember your human rights that we treated earlier in the previous episode. Fundamental human rights is very important. So the rule of law is saying that fundamental human rights must be respected, not only recognized, must be respected and guaranteed by the constitution of a country. Any government that does not respect and protect the fundamental human rights of the citizens, such a government is not a democratic government. I hope you are following. We are going to look at how are these laws applied in nature. These principles, how are they applied? How does it work? Then what are the importance? So we are going to look at the importance of rule of law. Importance of rule of law. Yes, rule of law is very germane, very important, very needed, is needed, is necessary in the democratic system of governance. Rule of law is very important and it must be observed if the citizens are to enjoy their fundamental human rights. If the less privileged are not to be subverted in society, if the unknown one are not to be denied their right as citizens of the country. Yes, individual must not suffer unjustly. Individual must not suffer unjustly. That's the first importance. Rule of law states that individual citizens citizens must not suffer unjustly. What do you mean by that? Yes. A committed crime. Let's see. Ibrahim has committed a crime and is being handed over to policeman. The policeman has no rights to pronounce him guilty or innocent. It is only the law court that has that power, that has that legal power to determine his offense and the degree of punishment to be meted out to him. So, individual citizen must not suffer unjustly. You not say you catch a suspect, that's why you call them suspects. You don't call them the guilty one. You don't call them guilty. You only call them suspect. That's why police always say suspect. It is the court that will determine whether that person is guilty or not. So individual citizen must not suffer unjustly. When a police arrests the suspect, he has no right to start kicking him, using gun to beat him, or shoot him wrong. Any policeman that does that will be punished. Secondly, rule of law. Makes the common man important. And feel secure, Yes, what do you mean by common man? Feel secure. Yes. Common man are the poor, the peasants, the unknown. Because of their level of economic status or education, they are common man. They are not connected. They don't have influence. So, because of the rule of law, it makes them to feel belongs to society, to the state, to the country, that nobody can treat them anyhow because there's a law. You can't treat him anyhow. You can't molest him because there's a law protecting their interests. So rule of law arrogates importance, made the life of a common man to be important, hard values to his life. Remember your rule of the fundamental human right. So rule of law states that common man should not be repressed, should not be oppressed, should not be punished unjustly. Thirdly, rule of law, we can use rule of law to classify whether a government is democratic or undemocratic. Any country under the democratic system of government must give credence, importance to the rule of law in its constitution. In fact, it is a acid test for any government to know, or for any country citizen to know whether the government is democratic or not. We use the rule of law as the litmus test. Yes, rule of law is used to categorize the government or type of government. Yes, rule of law enables us to determine whether a country is under a democratic system of governance. The United Nations, the moment any country claims that it's under democracy, they first of all look at its level of rule of law. They look at those keywords under the rule of law. Does he recognize the fundamental human rights of the citizen? Does he protect it? Or citizens are just suffering unjustly? Is there equality before the law? Are the citizens treated equally? Is the law obeyed by the powerful one or not? So they look at those areas to determine whether the government is democratic or not. During the military era, there's nothing like constitution. They throw away the constitution and use their decree and decree by force. The head of state will just give order to the supporting governors for various states. Go and carry out this order. They dare not complain. So, military is an aberrant to a democracy. It's not encouraged. It's not allowed. Another thing is that rule of law also grant equal protection, to all citizens. Of the country. Yes. But we said that the constitution of the country recognized the rule of law. And the fact that it recognized it, it also protected it and guaranteed it for every citizen, no matter your status. So rule of law is very important in a democratic system of governance. And there's no way a country or a government can claim to be democratic if the rule of law is not to be in that country. Now we are going to look at some of the problems that make the rule of law difficult to operate. No country in the world, in reality, history, supposed to be abiding, but in reality, we know that the rule of law is not strictly, is not 100% followed by the countries and nations of the world, even America, that claim to be the most powerful nation, not even the India, that claim to be the largest democracy in the world. Rule of law is still being violated. So I'm going to look at the problems. What made the rule of law very difficult to apply in reality? Problems of rule of law. Of the rule of law. Problems that citizens, that the country, that the governed and the government encounter in applying the rule of law in governance. Number one, yes, you say that every citizen is free to move around. That's civil liberty to move around. But when there is a problem in the country, you suspend that freedom. Like we are in pandemic now. Global disease that is affecting all human beings on earth. And no country is left out. So because of this pandemic, the governments of each country, we have to apply the necessary measure to ensure that the disease is not spread. Disease are not transferred anyhow to other citizens to make the country safe somehow. So that's why you are told now you cannot go to school. You can't go to parties. You can't even pray in the mosque. You can't go to the church because of the pandemic. So you can see that the problem of application of rule of law can be beset with the problem of when there is a state of emergency. That's the first problem. State of emergency. Emergency. There are many other examples of a state of emergency. Maybe there is a war. Maybe there is a communal crisis, and so on. Government might decide to give order of restricting the movement of the citizens to save life and property. Another area that makes rule of law very difficult to observe in reality . Yes, it's only government that declared the state of emergency, not any individual. Solely government has had that power. Another situation where the rule of law has problem in application is the immunity granting of immunity. Granting or extending of immunity to certain public officers and ambassadors. who are the public officers. Public officers. We have our president, the head of the executive, Senate president. We have the speaker. Vice President, Ambassador of other countries, of other countries. Then when we come to the executive, to the judiciary, the Chief of Staff, Attorney General and Chief Justice of the Federation, General and Chief Justice of the Federation. These people are exempted. When they commit a crime, they will be punished, but not when they are in office. The court will write down the crime they have committed, write it down. The very day they step out of office, the court will send police, go and bring them. That officer, come and give account of your CEOs. So when they are office, they are given immunity. We have executive immunity, parliamentary immunity, ambassadorial immunity. Another area where the rule of law find difficult is the lack of judicial independence. Yes. Most of the developing countries, we have the problem of a judicial independence. The judiciary is not free from the whim and caprices of the executive. Because it would detain the pipe, or would play the pipe, detain the two. The president is the one that appointed him, and he must be very careful the way he, so that we not step on the toe of the executive. So many. So there are other areas where the rule of law has problem in application. Delay justice. Popular saying that justice delay is justice denied. You go to the court, because there are files of the criminals before you reach your time. And the court may not even be ready to listen to your case the day you go to the court. Don't can you adjust it? A case can remain for the next 15 years while the accused will be in the custody of a correctional center. So they are denying the justice. Maybe the justice that should have been meted out to him just for 1 year, he might find himself 20 years. As you can see, because of this pandemic, the state government and the federal government, they have to open the gate of the correctional center and release some inmates who were denied justice for many years and so on. So rule of law has a lot of problem in its application. We cannot exhaust all these problems, but I will add one more. Strike action, declaration of strike, insanity, minor. I will explain them. Yes, what do you mean by strike? When the labor unions declare that every member must go on strike, whether you like it or not, you cannot say you are not going. That's a problem with the application of rule of law. Insanity, a madman who is mad, who is not normal. If he commits a crime, the court will not punish him. So it is the citizens that you should be careful the way they interact with him. Then minor, anybody below the age of 7 years, I refer to as minor. If they commit any crime, no court will be punished yet because they are still minor. So viewers and students at home, they have been able to treat the rule of law. We're able to see the definition of rule of law, the important concept or principle that underline the rule of law and the importance of rule of law in the democratic system of government, and the problem encountered in application of this rule of law. Next lesson, I will encourage you to read more at home. Go through your literature, your textbook to see more of this problem, and a lot more. So good. Remember, before I go, your personal hygiene is your personal responsibility. Make sure you wash your hand, avoid the crowded gathering, cough at the elbow of your arm, and so on. And before I go, let me give you my number again. In case you are just seeing us for the first time, my number is 081-682-33508. I know you are going to, you must have some questions to ask. So if you dial this number or you send it to my WhatsApp, I will get it and we answer your questions.